The first flight of the Ingenuity helicopter on Mars has been delayed while NASA works on an issue with its flight control software. It is the latest in a series of exciting Mars missions. News 11 meteorologist Angela Huddy is live at the McDonnell Planetarium with why all eyes are on the red planet. Angela?
Mike, NASA has successfully landed 5 rovers on Mars in the last 2 decades, each one with a more sophisticated mission than the last. Their latest effort, Perseverance, is quite literally digging into the search for previous life on the red planet.
I think, be it from science fiction, from all the books and movies that are out there, lots of people dream about going to Mars, and until that can be a reality, these rovers, these orbiters, those are the ways we're going to be able to learn about it.
NASA's Mars Perseverance Rover is searching for signs of ancient microbial life. The rover has a drill to collect samples of rock and soil, and it will store them in sealed tubes for pickup by a future mission.
It's not just this robotic explorer that's going to do some work and then be done, but it's the first stage of a longer mission, packaging up rock and core samples from Mars so that it will in the future be able to be transported back to Earth, allowing us to do a lot more research than we can with the limited equipment we're able to send there.
Hitching a ride to Mars with Perseverance, the Mars helicopter Ingenuity will test powered flight on another world for the first time.
Being able to fly, we can cover more ground on Mars than we could with a rover, and it will really lay the groundwork for future missions going even to places like Titan, a moon around Saturn.
But flying a drone on Mars sounds easier than it is.
Compared to our planet, Mars's atmosphere is only about 1% as thick as ours. And without that blanket of air, it's really difficult to achieve lift.
The Perseverance rover will also be testing technology for extracting oxygen from the Martian atmosphere, which is 96% carbon dioxide. The ultimate goal is to use Mars's natural resources to support human explorers.
A lot of people thinking about those manned missions to Mars. If you would like to learn more about Mars, you do not have to go to outer space. The Mission Mars exhibit right here at the St. Louis Science Center has 2 full galleries of information and an actual piece of the planet that you can interact with. So you're going to want to check that one out. To visit the Science Center right now, you do still need a free reservation. You can make those at slsc.org. Reporting live in Forest Park tonight, I'm meteorologist Angela Huddy, News 11.